In the heart of California, a geological time bomb is ticking. And here's where it gets really terrifying. The San Andreas Fault, which spans 1,200 kilometers across California, serves as the state's tectonic backbone. For more than a century, this fault has silently accumulated energy, waiting for the right moment to unleash its fury. As the Pacific and North American plates collide, their movement should be slow. Yet, they are locked, causing stress with each passing instant. When the fault eventually ruptures, California will be hit by a massive earthquake, leaving a trail of devastation in its wake. The scary truth is that this disaster is not a distant threat. It is an impending reality that will occur during our lives. Recent seismic activity in the Parkfield region has scientists concerned that a large earthquake, possibly on the scale of the deadly 7.9 magnitude quake that demolished San Francisco in 1906, is approaching. What exact seismic events or patterns have been observed in the Parkfield region? Can anything realistically reduce the chance of a 1906 scale earthquake? The answers may be more horrifying than you could have imagined. California's central region is home to a geological mystery that has been intriguing scientists for over a century. At the epicenter of this mystery lies the Parkfield section of the infamous San Andreas Fault, which slices through the sleepy town of Parkfield. With a population of just 18 people, Parkfield may be tiny, but it holds a seismic secret that has captivated scientists for generations. For reasons not fully understood, this part of the San Andreas Fault experiences moderate earthquakes around magnitude 6.0 at regular intervals. Historical records show a fascinating pattern with notable earthquakes in 1857, 1881, 1901, 1922, 1934, and 1966. In each case, the ground moved and trembled, sending regular bursts of shaking and vibration through the area. This consistent occurrence, averaging approximately 22 years between events, has turned Parkfield into a natural laboratory. The most recent quake happened on September 28, 2004, when a magnitude 6.0 tremor rocked the region. It was felt throughout the state and even in the San Francisco Bay Area. Though moderate, the quake provided valuable data, enabling scientists to examine the intricate dynamics of fault rupture and the indicators that precede seismic events. Recognizing the research opportunities presented by this fault segment, an ambitious initiative was started: the San Andreas Fault Observatory at Depth, SAFOD. Just north of Parkfield, a team of scientists embarked on a bold mission to drill into the core of the San Andreas Fault. By placing an array of sensors 2 to 3 kilometers deep within the Earth's crust, they had hoped to gain unparalleled insights into the intricate interplay of tectonic forces that drive earthquake behavior. Now, their data suggests the fault is once again building up substantial strain energy, much like the periods preceding previous quakes. What's more, the broader San Andreas Fault system has exhibited heightened seismic activity in recent years. Smaller earthquakes, while not necessarily a direct precursor to a large event, can sometimes be a sign that major stress is accumulating along the fault. Of course, predicting the timing and magnitude of earthquakes remains an imperfect science. But with the clock ticking, we will explore the recent unusual activity in the San Andreas Fault, what the history of seismic activities in the region can tell us about the recent observations, and why we might be on the verge of a major earthquake. But before we dive into the terrifying details, let's establish some context. Southern California is no stranger to earthquakes, with residents experiencing an average of 10,000 quakes per year. Most of these quakes are too small to be felt, but the sheer number is a stark reminder that the state is crisscrossed by 500 active faults, any of which could unleash a nightmare of shaking at any moment. But there's one major fault line that stands out from the rest, and that's the San Andreas Fault. This infamous fault runs for 800 miles, stretching from above San Francisco, past Los Angeles, across the Mexican border, and into the Gulf of California. The San Andreas Fault has been around for an astonishing 30 million years, created by the meeting of two tectonic plates, the Pacific and the North American. To understand how the San Andreas Fault works, imagine two very slow and very heavy trains lumbering past each other in opposite directions. One train, the Pacific Plate, is heading northwest, while the other, the North American Plate, is heading southeast. You'd think they'd be in constant motion, ever so slowing passing each other without a hitch. But that's not what happens. Instead, the trains are so weighed down with luggage and passengers that they get caught on each other and come to a stop. Rather than separating them, the engine drivers keep adding more coal until a huge amount of energy builds up. Finally, that energy gets to be too much and everything snaps. The train lurches forward, away from each other, causing their carriages to shake and making a whole bunch of people fall over. That, in a very simplified form, is what's happening with the San Andreas Fault. In the 30 million years of its existence, the two plates have moved an impressive 350 miles past each other. But aside from a relatively calm section in central California, they've been doing it in sudden bursts, each of which means one thing and one thing only: earthquake time. Technically, this is known as a strike-slip fault, less common than other types, but that's not what makes the San Andreas so noteworthy. The reason geologists are concerned about the San Andreas Fault can be summed up with a single worrying statistic. The vast majority of Californians live in the area around the fault. That includes everyone in LA, San Francisco, San Bernardino, San Jose, Santa Barbara, and many more. In some places, towns have been built directly on top of the fault, like San Francisco's Bay Area Rapid Transit System, which runs a tunnel right through the middle of the fault. All this means that any quake caused by the San Andreas Fault has the potential to be devastating. Take the 1994 Northridge quake, caused by one of San Andreas' secondary faults. It struck the San Fernando Valley at around 4:30 a.m., measuring 6.7 on the Richter scale. That quake collapsed buildings, killing 57 people and causing around $200 billion in damages. That's scary, right? Well, just know that the Northridge quake wasn't even near to being the big one. It was barely a hiccup in terms of what the San Andreas Fault is capable of. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. To get a glimpse of what it's like when the San Andreas really ruptures, we need to go back in time to witness one of the worst natural disasters in U.S. history. The Great San Francisco Earthquake of 1906 is a chilling example of the San Andreas Fault's destructive power. On April 18, 1906, a massive earthquake struck at 5:12 a.m., measuring around 7.9 on the Richter scale. The quake lasted for a terrifying 48 seconds, causing widespread destruction and fires that burned for days. The aftermath was nothing short of apocalyptic. Over 80% of San Francisco was destroyed, leaving hundreds of thousands of people homeless. The death toll was estimated to be around 3,000, although some reports put it much higher. The economic losses were staggering, with estimates ranging from $350 million to $500 million in 2006 dollars, equivalent to over $13 billion today. Now, here's the big question. Although the region has been prone to many disasters in the past, how are we sure of an impending earthquake in the region? The San Andreas Fault is a name etched in the minds of disaster-conscious Americans, thanks in part to the dramatic portrayals in the film industry. But the reality is just as gripping. The fault line has left a trail of devastation in its wake, from the 1906 San Francisco earthquake to the 1857 Southern California quake. While the 21st century has seen a relative calm, scientists warn that a major earthquake is overdue, with a significant likelihood of a massive tremor striking the fault line within the next 50 years. Predicting earthquakes, however, remains an elusive task, unlike other natural forces such as hurricanes, tornadoes, or wildfires. But a recent study published in Frontiers in Earth Science hints that a section of this notorious fault may be building up to a significant event. The paper raises crucial questions about the possibility of detecting preparatory phases before major earthquakes and whether these phases are common to all major tremors. The focal point of this study is the section of the fault near Parkfield, a small town in central California with a population of just over 24. This seismically dynamic location is characterized by a unique behavior, with the fault creeping at a rate of 1.4 inches per year north of Parkfield, while remaining locked in place to the south. The U.S. Geological Survey, USGS, labels this stretch as a transition zone between the creeping and locked behavior of the fault. Historically, earthquakes in this area occur every 22 years, but the last quake took place in 2004, 14 years ahead of schedule. Scientists seized the opportunity to collect data, which revealed valuable insights into earthquake physics and the effects of strike-slip earthquakes worldwide. The new study's lead author, Luca Malaganini, suggests that the area is now entering the end of its quiet phase. Malaganini's research highlights the significance of sound wave attenuation, which showed distinct patterns in the 2004 quake. As stress builds up, cracks form, affecting permeability and the behavior of high and low frequency waves. A striking similarity was observed in the region in 2021, with the attenuation of high frequency waves dropping 6 weeks prior to the earthquake. While the fault near Parkfield has skipped quakes before, Malaganini warns that an eruption is likely soon. But, an insane curiosity, we are not one for sensationalism, so it's important to state that in geological time, soon means any time from now to the next 100,000 years. What other evidence supports the threat of the southern San Andreas Fault? In 2006, a renowned geophysicist named Yuri Fialko from the Scripps Institution of Oceanography conducted a study that set off alarm bells in the scientific community. Through a meticulous analysis of data gathered over decades, Fialko and his team uncovered a deeply unsettling revelation. The southern segment of the San Andreas Fault had reached a critical stress threshold, priming it for a catastrophic rupture of magnitude 7.0 or greater. This finding carried chilling implications. The region surrounding Los Angeles, a sprawling metropolitan area home to millions, was sitting atop this seismic time bomb. The southern stretch of the fault, extending through San Bernardino, Riverside, and Imperial counties in California, as well as the Mexican border area, had not experienced a significant release of pent-up tectonic strain for over three centuries. As the relentless grind of the Pacific and North American plates continued, immense forces were steadily building, straining the fault line to its limit. With each passing year, the risk of catastrophic rupture grew even higher. Fialko's study painted a grim picture of the potential devastation. A major earthquake along the southern San Andreas Fault would unleash destruction unlike anything seen in modern times. Older buildings, ill-equipped to withstand such violent shaking, could crumble like houses of cards. Soil liquefaction in coastal areas could destabilize entire neighborhoods. Beyond the immediate epicenter, the shockwaves could ripple outward, rattling the foundations of the region's critical infrastructure. Major transportation arteries could be severed, cutting off vital supply lines and emergency response efforts. Now, advanced satellite-based geodetic techniques such as GPS and INSAR have allowed scientists to precisely measure the gradual deformation and movement of the Earth's surface around the San Andreas Fault. These measurements confirm that the southern segment is accumulating strain at a rapid pace, with the Pacific and North American plates grinding past each other at a rate of approximately 35 to 40 millimeters per year. Yet amidst this threatening scenario, the study also underscored the urgent need for preparedness and mitigation efforts. The scientific community has sounded the alarm, and now it is up to local authorities, emergency services, and the public to heed the warning and take the necessary steps to safeguard lives and minimize the potential for catastrophic loss. Now over to you. Do you think the next San Andreas Fault earthquake will happen anytime soon? Is there a region you think is more prone to a more urgent earthquake? Share your opinion in the comments below. Click on the next video that pops up on your screen. It explains why the new Madrid Fault disaster could hit the middle of the US. Thanks for watching.